In this video, I'm going to talk to you about a rare, unusual, and awful MS symptom, pathologic itching. If you'd like to hear more about this awful itch, stay tuned because that learning starts right now. Howdy! Thanks for learning about MS with me, Aaron Boster. I started this YouTube channel to help my own MS clinic patients learn between clinic visits, and it's my hope that through these videos, I can help you learn too. Today's topic, pathologic itching. A few months back, I published a video entitled Rare and Unusual Multiple Sclerosis Symptoms. I'll throw a link up above in case you haven't seen that yet, and I'll include a link in the description down below. I've shared with you before, I absolutely love to read comments, and there are plenty of comments from this particular video on unusual symptoms. As I read through them the other night, it dawned on me that many, many people struggle with itching. And so, although it is a rare symptom, I wanted to spend a few minutes in this video highlighting it, addressing it, talking about what causes it, and most importantly, what can be done to combat pathologic itching in multiple sclerosis. For starters, I like to explain that I'm not talking about a little itch. Pathologic itching can be severe, profound, and it can erode the quality of your life. And when you think about pathologic itching in MS, I want you to think about neuropathic pain. Pathologic itching, in my opinion, is a form of neuropathic pain. Now, before I drop some medical knowledge on you related to itching and multiple sclerosis, I wanted to read some of the many comments left in that previous video about itching. John Neufeld wrote, "The pathologic itching is no joke. Every time I go to sleep, my left ear feels like there's worms crawling inside. Very hard to get a good night's rest." Rabin Sarah wrote, "Pathologic itching. I had this for a year or so before my MS diagnosis. After getting on medicine, the symptom has gone away." Capolucci wrote, "I have had an unknown itching that lasts for months. I haven't had it in quite a while, thank God. You have given me validity on a few symptoms I was told had nothing to do with MS, like the itching and cog fog. Again, I love your videos. You should come to New York City and do a Q&A. Now that sounds like a lot of fun. Kyle writes, "Hi, Dr. Boster. Once, maybe 20 years ago, before my diagnosis, I also had severe itching for no reason. It was on my head, under my scalp. I had just come to the conclusion that bugs of some sort had crawled in my ear while I was sleeping and laid eggs that were hatching on my brain, causing it to itch nonstop. It was unbearable. Luckily, it only lasted 2 months. Nothing I could do could ease the itching." Sky Scarlet writes, "The itching I had back in 2014, when I had a major relapse. My neuro said that MS doesn't cause itching. I knew it was a symptom." Megan D writes, "Ah, yes, the itching. It's so random and so incredibly frustrating. Benadryl sometimes helps, but I sometimes wonder how much of the relief is psychological, since there doesn't really seem to be a good reason for the itching to start with." MS Strong with a Service Dog writes, "The itching is something that I go through and it's awful. I can scratch my legs until they bleed and my head itches all the time. And no, I don't have lice. I've checked." Renee writes, "Pathologic itching is maddening. Nothing seems to work. Does stop after a long rest period. Activity starts it again." Janine writes, "I have itching in the small of my back. I bought so many different lotions and potions. I found a spray called Burn Relief with lidocaine. I still don't know why it works, but I have tried everything. I use it once a day. And I find also some clothing materials can irritate the itching. Soft clothing is recommended." Wow. Let me start by saying thank you to my viewers that were kind and brave enough to write in and share their own personal experiences with pathologic itching. Hopefully, in reviewing what they've written, it gives you a better sense of what I'm talking about. The fact that this is a severe symptom, which can erode the quality of your life. And with that preamble, let's transition to some medical knowledge. I want to share with you what we believe causes pathologic itching in MS, and most importantly, what we can do to fight back. To review some basic neuroanatomy, you have receptors in your skin which can detect itch. They send a message through the nerve to your spinal cord. your spinal cord sends the message up to your brain where it's interpreted as, I'm itching. In the setting of pathologic itching, there is either a problem with A, the peripheral nerve, sending excessive itch signals to the brain, or B, a problem with the spinal cord, which is not dampening that signal. You see, the goal of the spinal cord in this pathway is to dampen or diminish the signal coming in from the nerve. It minimizes that signal so not a very large itch signal is sent to the brain. When you have spinal cord damage from multiple sclerosis, or less commonly, when you have brain damage from multiple sclerosis, it can interfere with those inhibitory pathways. So the result is that you have disinhibition. You turn off the off, and the result is a robust itch message, which is not suppressed by the spinal cord going up to the brain. The result is itching. Now, considering that there can be both peripheral nervous system nerve problems and central nervous system brain and spinal cord problems that can cause pathologic itching, it stands to reason that we see conditions both in the peripheral nervous system and in the central nervous system which can cause this horrible symptom. If we think for a moment outside of multiple sclerosis in the world of peripheral nervous problems, things like herpetic zoster, shingles, can cause this pathologic itching, as can different types of peripheral neuropathies. But that's clearly outside the scope of this MS video. If we turn our attention to the central nervous system, brain and spinal cord, there's again multiple different conditions that can cause damage to the brain and spinal cord that can result in itching. You can see this in the setting of things such as multiple sclerosis and its cousin, neuromyelitis optica. Both can cause notorious itching. Considering the neural anatomy of itch, the spinal cord is oftentimes a culprit. Here you see an MRI of the spinal cord with a classic posteriorly located MS lesion. Now this lesion anatomically is found in what we call the dorsal horn. And damage to interneurons of the spinal cord in the dorsal horn can lead to pathologic itching. Turning our attention to the neural anatomy of itch in the brain, functional neuroimaging teaches us something rather profound. The parts of the brain that become activated during itch overlap with parts of the brain that become active during pain, giving credence to the idea that neuropathic itching is a type of neuropathic pain. A few quick comments about the neurochemistry of pathologic itching. If you have a bug bite and have a sudden itch, where there's a welt and it's red and you scratch, that's caused by a histamine pathway. And I want you to associate histamine pathways with acute itching. That is not what we're talking about here. Chronic, long-term neuropathic itching does not use histamine pathways. They use different pathways, which are much more akin to pain pathways than what we see with histamine. This might in part explain why taking antihistamines for chronic neuropathic itching doesn't tend to work too well. And now I'd like to turn our attention to treatment. What can be done to combat pathologic itching? I'll start by saying that this is a very challenging symptom to treat. I personally have struggled with some of my patients to overcome pathologic itching. Nonetheless, I want to share with you the most common pathway neurologists take when trying to beat this symptom. Now, what I'm laying out for you is an escalation model, meaning we would try the first thing before escalating to the second thing, before escalating to the third thing. And in some patients, we may have to keep plugging away, trying more and more invasive techniques in order to find resolution. So for starters, we would begin with behavioral measures. Now, what do I mean by this? When you have itching, you reflexively go to scratch. And some people will literally find that they're scratching themselves in their sleep. And so behavioral measures are geared towards preventing damaging yourself, preventing scratching yourself, or actually causing dermal damage. And so these can be things like guarding your hands and mitts while you sleep. The next step would be to consider topical treatments, covering the area of skin where the itching is manifesting. Now, I've had some success in the past using lidocaine preparations. And there's a myriad of lotions and potions that include lidocaine, which could be considered. We also have had some success using medicines like capsaicin, which can be applied directly to the skin. When topical agents are not successful, we turn our attention to systemic agents, typically pills that we take, which are intended to decrease the excessive firing of these neurons, sending excessive neuro messages saying, itch, itch. Now, some of the most successful treatments that we have are anti-seizure medicines. Anti-seizure medicines are invented to stabilize cell membranes and stop inappropriate neuronal firing. And whereas this can help stop seizures, it can also help stop other excessive neuronal firing in the setting of neuropathic pain and here in the setting of neuropathic itching. And so anti-seizure medications can be quite helpful in some patients. If pills are not found to be successful, we turn our attention to injections. And injecting local anesthetic or injecting botulinum toxin has been shown to be helpful in some people. When these maneuvers are unsuccessful, we turn our attention to medicine by Edison and neurostimulation. In specific, a technique called cutaneous field stimulation can be helpful to knock out the sensations of itching. Lastly, I don't want us to forget that certain medicines can have side effects of itching. And as part of the algorithm to treat itching, we have to critically look at each and every medicine to make sure there isn't a culprit. Similarly, we don't want to ignore postherpetic pain from Zoster or associated neuropathies with diabetes. These aren't related to MS, but sometimes nature can be too generous, and we can in fact have more than one cause of a given symptom. And there you have it. A quick didactic on a rare but awful neurological symptom in MS, that of pathologic itching. I hope that you found this helpful. As always, I would absolutely love to hear from you. Please include your comments, your experiences, your questions down in the section below. I will enjoy reading them and I promise to respond. If you enjoyed this video and would like to see other videos like it, please take a moment and subscribe to the channel. Do that right now by clicking that little red button. And until my next video, take care.